Hello, and I bring you greetings from St. Mark's as I share with you a little of what to expect if you come and join us for worship at 10:30 on Sunday morning. To say, first of all, of course, is that we're really looking forward to being back together as a church family. We know that it will be a much smaller congregation because of the restrictions that are in place, but we do look forward to worshipping together here in this place. And it's been really encouraging to hear how well our online services have been received over the past few months. But of course, we do look forward to being together back in this place together as a worshipping community. Now, just to say, first of all, that at all times in the church grounds and in the building, 2 metres social distancing should be applied. So if you come and you see others out and about outside the church grounds, please do remember to keep your distance. I'm afraid we're not allowed to shake hands or hugs or anything like that for a while yet. So the general rules that apply in our community also apply, of course, outside in our church grounds. Inside, of course, 2 metres will be observed as pews are specifically designated for use. You can see how some of them have been closed by use of ribbon to show us which ones are available for use. If you'd like to wear a face mask, you're very welcome to do so. We want you to know that, that if that makes you feel more comfortable, please do feel free to wear a face covering if that is your preference. So as you arrive at the church, there will be sanitizers at the entrance. Davy is going to squirt our hands. There's also sanitizers inside the church porch as well. So everybody will clean their hands as we come into the building. Stewards will show us to our seats, whether upstairs or downstairs. We will be guided to our seat. Now, I know we all have favoured seats to sit in. I can understand that. But please, can I ask you to look beyond that and sit in the pew that you are led to. We'd really appreciate your help on that. We will begin at the front and work our way back. Again, I know that's maybe not our preference to sit up the front, but we will work our way towards the back. Again, this is for the safety of us all. And what that allows is, of course, that less people passing you whenever you're sitting in your pew as the pews are filled up from the front to the back. So we come in through the front door, shown to our seats, and service sheets will be found in the pew. Now, the service sheets are there because hymn books and prayer books and Bibles are all taken away. They're not available in the pew that you'll be using. That's, again, it's just in obedience with the guidelines. So the service sheets are there, and there will be pens. And the reason for the pens are, of course, so that you can write in your name and address and phone number. We need to record everybody who comes to church for contact tracing purposes. So you can use the pen in the pew, or if you bring your own pen, that's probably even better. And you write your name on the service sheet, everybody who's with you, and then just leave them in the pew afterwards, and they will be collected and stored accordingly. The service should proceed in a relatively normal fashion. The big omission being, of course, is congregational hymn singing. Yes, we're all going to miss that. That is going to be something that is going to be a little bit strange. But what we will do is we're going to have those who have been singing during our online services are going to record the hymns. And if you're here in church, you will hear the hymns sung and you'll be able to follow along the words on your service sheet. So there will be hymns in church. And for those of you who watch online, you will see the singers and the words on the screen as you are used to doing so at this time. So hymns will be followed, and we will worship along with the words here in the church. After the service, those sitting at the front will be led out, and we will depart from the church using the two choir vestry and clergy vestry doors. And for those of you in the gallery, you'll come up one side and you'll go down the other, and you'll be guided accordingly. It's just, again, to facilitate a flow of people in and out of the building whilst maintaining social distancing and ensuring that we touch as little of the same surfaces as possible. So these, I know, might seem a little bit off-putting, but please don't let these steps take away from a desire to be together as a church family in worship. Please see them as safety measures rather than restrictions. And just to say that we'd love to see you and you'll be very, very welcome. If, however, we're at capacity, I hope you'll understand if you're told that, I'm sorry, we're full. I hope you'll understand that if we achieve capacity, as you can see, there's a lot of curtailing of available pews because of the social distancing. So we don't envisage that might happen, but if it does, can I ask for your understanding if that happens. Now, whether you should or shouldn't come to church, a lot of this is up to you. But first of all, to say that if you're anxious and you're worried and don't feel you're quite ready, don't worry. That's completely fine. Please take your time and come and join us whenever you feel the time is right for you. If you're shielding or anyone in your household is shielding, you should definitely stay at home and wait until you're medically advised that it's safe for you to be out and about in the community. So please, if you're shielding, please observe the guidance that you've been given. Thirdly, if you or someone you know has displayed COVID-like symptoms in recent times, please, please stay at home. Seek medical advice before you go out anywhere, never mind to church. But if you've had any of those symptoms, what we've heard a lot about, the cough, the temperature, the change of taste or smell, if you've had any of those, or someone in your home or you've been up close to recently has had as well, please, please stay at home and seek medical advice, even go for a test. But when it's safe for you to be here, I'd love to see you, and you'll be made very welcome, I promise. Now, the Sunday service will be recorded every week, and it will be recorded using a video camera up there beside the sound desk behind me, and the service will be recorded and uploaded to the usual places as quickly as possible. It won't be available at 8:30 in the morning, and it won't be available at 11:30 in the morning, but it'll probably in around lunchtime. We'll do our best to have it available as quickly as possible after the service concludes. A lot of it depends on how quickly the internet is running on Sunday morning. Just to say that when I think of this, the reopening of the church and being back together, I can't help but think of Psalm 84, which speaks of a worshipper who long to be in their place of worship. I cannot help but that is a very appropriate psalm for us to reflect upon as we approach this time of being together as a church community here in this church and, of course, in other churches which are opening up in either this Sunday or in the weeks ahead. This Sunday, as we worship together, we pray that the service that is participated in, whether from here in this church or in our homes, that it will be for the pleasure of Almighty God. We look forward to worshiping together, and I wish you every blessing, and I hope to see you all soon. God bless.